This week it's finally time to talk about the progress of Starship again, with a focus on the developments at Boca Chica spaceport, because let us tell you, there's a lot going on there.
Then we want to talk about the new SpaceX Crew Dragon animation that was just uploaded before New Year's Eve, about upcoming SpaceX Falcon 9 launches and the announcement of the Chandrayaan 3 moon mission. A lot of stuff happening in space, so stay tuned!
A new year always means new progress for Starship and Super Heavy. Now, since the COCO site in Florida was put into hibernation, a lot has happened at their Boca Chica facilities, which will henceforth just call Boca Chica Spaceport, in honor of Mos Eisley Spaceport, of course. We have some highly interesting aerial shots here from Sam Sun over on Twitter, who made some very impressive drone shots of the Boca Chica facilities. Now we can see that new buildings are being erected, with a lot of plinths for Starship construction, as well as quite a few new tents. The biggest tent is this one here, which was still missing in the aerial shots, but now is being built and should be finished as of now. This here is how the tent looked on the 30th of December, by the way. It measures 45 by 75 meters and will offer almost 3,400 square meters of construction space for Starship. Now, we of course know this type of tent very well from Tesla, especially from the Tesla production hell time, where a lot of Model 3s were manufactured in such a tent. Now back to Boca Chica. Nearer to the Gulf we can see the fuel storage facilities with the liquefied methane and oxygen tanks, and we can also see Starhopper. Now we know that Elon often said that Starhopper will act as a test stand to test newly developed Raptor engines, and that's exactly what it will do here. And therefore, of course, it makes sense to have the Starhopper at the liquefied methane and oxygen facility.
The newest Starship iteration is now, by the way, not referred to as Starship Mark III anymore, but rather Starship Serial Number 1. So Starship SN1, as we can see in this tweet here by Elon himself. We can see that the building parts for this prototype have already arrived. For example, the tank dome. Assembly of Starship Serial Number 1 will start still this month. And if the previous times are any indication, we assume Starship SN1 will be finished within 4 to 5 months, with the first test flights by mid-year. Of course, Elon has much more aggressive time windows, but we believe that they are a bit too optimistic, because he says that the prototype could already fly by March. We think that we can see the first test flights still this year though. What we will also very likely see this year, and probably at the latest by mid-year, is the first crewed launch of SpaceX's Crew Dragon. SpaceX has only recently, on the 30th of December, released a new animation showing how a crewed launch of the Crew Dragon capsule would look. So basically a nice New Year's present, showing us what we can expect to see this year. In the latest update from Elon, he stated that the hardware will be ready at the Cape by February. And after a few more months of safety review, the Crew Dragon capsule with crew will probably be launched sometime in the second quarter. A lot of course depends on the in-flight abort test, which is scheduled to still take place this month. But if this goes well, we think that the chances that the Crew Dragon launches the first crew to the ISS in the second quarter are quite high.
It will be so funny to see Boeing's reaction to that. We cannot wait to see their reaction. We think that the recent failure to dock to the ISS will have some impact for the crewed launches with Starliner. Therefore, we think that this animation here is a quite accurate depiction of what we'll see in 2020. And it will be an extremely important milestone for SpaceX, because it will be the first time that humans are launched into space on a SpaceX rocket, which will, in our opinion, pave the way for further joint missions with NASA. And hopefully this will also convince NASA that SpaceX rockets and SpaceX technology is extremely reliable, and hopefully the pro-SpaceX elements at NASA will get stronger due to that and push more and more towards joint SpaceX and NASA moon missions. and we are pretty sure that this year marks the beginning of SpaceX's crewed future space flights, for the time being with Crew Dragon, but later on, of course, with Starships, with the destination Moon in 2024 and Mars in the late 2020s, maybe early 2030s. But the first crewed launch of Crew Dragon will be the first step towards the colonization of the solar system, the first step towards our multi-planetary future, and we should always keep that in mind, and therefore we are extremely excited to see the first launches of a crew with Crew Dragon towards the ISS this year.
In the non-crewed department, SpaceX is also extremely busy, actually more busy than ever, with a whopping 3 launches in January alone. First, we of course have our 2 Starlink launches, one only in a few hours after the release of this video here, so according to plans at 2:19 UTC tomorrow morning. The other Starlink launch sometime in January, with the date not being fixed yet. It's really nice to see how often Starlink satellites are being launched now, because we all know how important Starlink is for our future in space, due to the huge revenue it will generate for SpaceX. Then, of course, the in-flight abort test of our Crew Dragon capsule on the 11th of January, which will be a suborbital flight, by the way, with the only purpose of testing Crew Dragon's in-flight abort mechanism, which is a vital safety measure for future crewed missions to the ISS. So a lot is happening at SpaceX, and they are expanding just like crazy. And what is meanwhile happening internationally? Well, India came forth with the news that they want to launch another Chandrayaan moon mission, the Chandrayaan 3. We've already talked about the Chandrayaan moon mission in this video here, where we were quite sad that the Chandrayaan 2 didn't manage to successfully land on the moon back in September last year.
Now, why was the Chandrayaan 2 mission so absolutely awesome? Well, because it would have foreseen a landing at 70 degrees southern latitude, so not far away from the lunar south pole. Now, it would have included a lander and a rover, where the primary mission goal would have foreseen the rover to search for water ice, which is known to exist in the perpetually dark craters near the lunar south pole, with Shackleton Crater directly at the lunar south pole being the most famous one. Now, of course, we know that water ice will play a pivotal role in the colonization of the moon and for future moon bases, so the lunar south pole is a very good site for setting up a future moon base. Now, water ice is thought to exist also a bit further away from the poles, and it would have been very interesting indeed to see what the Indian rover would have discovered. But hopefully now we will see exactly this happen with Chandrayaan 3, because it will also consist of a lander and a rover, very similar to Chandrayaan 2, and will attempt a soft landing this year in November if everything hopefully goes according to plan. We really hope India will make it, joining the illustrious club of nations that have landed probes on the moon as the fourth nation after the US, Russia and China. We really hope to see more and more nations attempt to land probes on the moon in the future.
Actually, our preferred vision of the future is this one here, where nations such as India won't attempt to build their own human-rated moon rockets or moon landers, but will instead charter Starship and use the Starship Super Heavy system to accomplish their moon missions, or just do joint moon missions with NASA or SpaceX. This would be a highly interesting development and probably the most efficient way to establish future moon colonies. An international moon colony is certainly our favorite vision for the future. Let's see if our New Year's wish will be granted.
So what do you think? Will the Crew Dragon fly to the ISS in quarter 2 this year, as we suspect?
That would be really awesome, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what do you think about the new nomenclature for the Starship prototype? So SN1 now instead of Mark 3.
I think it's cool. And do you think India will make it with Chandrayaan 3 to the moon this year? We certainly hope so. That would be nice.
The more moon missions, the better, right?
Yes. The more international moon missions, the better.
And if you liked our video, we would really appreciate it if you would give us a like and maybe also share it with your friends.
Mm-hmm.
This would really help this channel to grow, and we will make even better videos for you.
So be sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, because we keep uploading videos on these topics: futurism, future technologies, disruptive technology, space stuff, twice a week. So then, see you next time.